think we're doing this thing. Good morning. Light. Okay, we're good. Hello, everybody. It's me. It's Ellie Mae. I went to my studio all by myself, and I am ready to start working out because I have been sitting all day yesterday. Well, I did clean my basement in case some of you didn't see the post, but anyway, so I am here and we're going to stretch and we're going to work out. So I am in dire need of some exercise and you guys should be exercising too. I hope you are getting out for walks and stuff, right? All right, so we're going to do the chair routine, but we're going to stretch just a little bit to get started. So come and join me, please. So I feel like I'm not alone in doing this thing. Hello, everybody. And in. Before we get started, because you will feel it the next day if you don't, so don't forget. That feels really good. I know I should probably like do a Zumba class, but my Zumba classes are usually during the week, and at the end of my workday, I'm exhausted. So I woke up this morning and I was like, all right, let's do a chair class. So we'll be all sexy and suave and whatever in our pajamas. I actually put on makeup today, so it's a big day for me. I don't know about you guys. So we're just gonna go ahead and stretch out our legs and our calves. So, because when you're doing chair stuff, you're gonna use a lot of core and you're gonna use a lot of, we're doing a lot of leg work too. So it's a workout. So you sweat, don't forget water. Thanks for being here, you guys. This will be really fun. I'm excited, super excited. All right, roll your shoulders. Other way. Good, head roll. Exercise will make us happy. Don't forget. In, big stretch out, pull your arms back and in, back out, and let's do some arm swings. Cool, much better. Good. And that has 8 million different kinds of music on my laptop. So now we're going to Christmas, apparently. Let me hang on a second. We're changing this. Mr. Hanky the Christmas Poo. Let's not do that one. That's better. All right, let's stretch our legs. Hips. Hip. Hip. Other side. Look right in my face. For eight. One. I was born standing. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Now slide them both ways. One. Three. Four. Put a little bounce in it. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. Now scoop your hips. Hip. Hip. Hip, hip, hip. Arm. And arm. And do some wrist circles. A lot of us are sitting on the keyboard or on our phones and we're not stretching our wrists at all. Right? Now do it the other way. Wrist circles all the way down. Good. And shoulders again. Shoulder, shoulder, shoulder. Go forward. Both. Shoulder. Hello, everybody. Thanks for watching. And let's drop down. Good. We're just moving. Other side. This makes me think of Skylight and Honey Rider doing this song. long time ago. They do this as a duet. It's so cute. Alright, cool. Are we stretched? Warm? Good. Alright. This is a chair. Get one. Get one now. There's multiple kinds of chairs. This is one we have in the studio all the time. So, this is really fun. Something that slides and you're not going to fall over on them. Okay? Ba-da! Yeah. Alright. So, one that you're not going to fall over on. So a lot of chair stuff has to do with balance and finding where you're going to sit on it so that when you're doing stuff on your chair that you don't fall on the floor. But if you do, don't worry about it because we're in quarantine and nobody can see you. So, and we've all fallen off of chairs at some point. I think everybody in the whole burlesque troupe for all the 6 years that I've been doing this has fallen off a chair at some point. So don't worry about it. Some of us fall off chairs more often than others, but all right. This is your chair. So I just want to show you some tricks and tips about when you're dealing with your chair. I know some people have gone to like Habitat for Humanity, you know who you are, and have tried out all the chairs to find the right chair that fits them and suits them. So we have three different kinds of chairs here. This is one of the ones that I like. So this is just a standard restaurant chair. All right, when you sit on your chair, a lot of it, you're going to be up on your toes. I forgot to put my heels on, but I'm going to do this without heels, so it's good. You're going to be on your toes, because otherwise you're going to be flat-footed, and it's not nearly as pretty. Also, you're working your calves, so calf work. You're on your toes all the time. Put your feet against the bottom of the chair legs like that, so you can support yourself just a little bit more when you're doing it, if you can, but you're gonna be doing most of all this on your toes. This is why it's very important that you continue to stretch. So you can just do basic stretches when you're standing, if you go to work, if you're at home, if you're doing the dishes, go up on your toes, it's great. When you put your foot on your chair, you're also, most of the time, you're gonna go onto the ball of your foot and your heel is gonna be up, okay? So that you're not gonna be on your tiptoes, of course, but you're gonna be on the ball of your foot. Cool, right? Let's do some fun stuff. So, getting started, feet together, and then you're going to push your legs out, out. I'm wearing dance bottoms, so I don't know what you guys are wearing. Okay, so your legs are spread, and you're balancing your feet on your legs, like so and so. Great. Maybe one of the tricks is you're going to scoot forward on your chair, so you are close to the edge of your chair, but not so far to the edge of the chair that your chair tips forward and off. Okay? So if you look at where I'm sitting on my chair, this is where I'm sitting on my chair. Okay? All right, cool. What does that say? Everyone watching each other, it's too fun. All right, so here we are, and we just opened our legs. Now here we go, and then what we're gonna do is you're gonna take your inside leg and push it down and open, push it down and open. So your knee is gonna go kind of parallel to the floor. If you're flat-footed when you do this, it makes it really hard to bend your knee and to move it. So that's one of the other reasons, is because you're gonna pivot off the ball of your foot like so, and pivot like so. Fun thing we do, a number that we do, we're not gonna do it today, but then you slide down your legs, pop your head up, okay? Let's try that again, and slide, pop your head, great, cool, and pivot, and down without falling off your chair, and pop it back up, good. Take one leg, and you're gonna cross the other one. Put your hands on the chair a little bit behind you if you need to for support, because you are very far forward on your chair. So if you need to, you can up. Notice you're still up on your toe. And then this toe is pointed because we don't want to have floppy toes. We're going to have pretty toes. We're going to have elegant toes, nice toes. So we just crossed our leg here. We're going to switch it. Ready? Switch. when you go to cross your other leg, you actually have to lean back. So let's go the other way and leaning back. You might feel foolish when you first do it, but with you have all this room because you're so far forward on your chair, so you can lean back. And one more time, lean back. You guys trying it? Try it. It's kind of cool. It looks neat too, and you're doing a big fan with your legs. So, we just did a big fan with our legs. Peek, peek. Good. And then we're gonna slide down our leg. Maybe we're gonna put our legs back together again. We're gonna open them again. Good. And slide maybe just to our knees and back up. Do a little head roll. Good. Hey, you got it. So, what did we learn? And legs together, legs out, slide, come back up, cross your legs, and fan. Then maybe you're gonna stand up. Okay, we're gonna go around our chair to the side. Now, your inclination would be to put your foot onto the chair like so, and that's fine if you're gonna do a twirl on your chair, but otherwise if you're just gonna show off your leg, your foot's gonna go up, it's gonna be the foot that's closest to your audience, your downstage leg, and then your leg's gonna go down and you're gonna come back up. If you wanna do a twirl, if you are feeling bold, you can, let's do one thing at a time. One leg up, you can lean on your chair. So give it a try. Lean. Lean. Straight leg if you can. Out. This is very good for your calves and your thighs and your butt. And it feels really good. You're gonna push your chair around. There you go. Okay. You feeling ready? You ready to try it? And foot up on your chair. Go up on your chair. Gonna see that again? Okay. So it's here, your upstage leg, the one that's closest to the back of your chair. Up, grab the back of your chair, do a little spin. How are you doing? How about this one? How about we spin off of our chair? So leg up, spin, and leg down. You try that again? Take it real slow, leg up, pull yourself up on your chair, do a little spin, leg down. Just try it one more time. Leg up, little spin. Make sure you have a back on your chair so you have something to grab onto. Otherwise, you're gonna, like if you're on a stool, you're going to fall and it's going to hurt a lot. Okay, so we just did a spin. And a lean, other leg up, good. All right, you guys are gonna make craft your own routine in no time, right? Cool, should we do this with some music? Should we mess around with what we've got going on? Are you guys having fun? Is anybody having a good time? I hope. Okay, let's put some music on and we'll give it a shot with what we've learned so far, okay? All right. Oh boy. Okay, someone else in the class, a couple of performers have done this number too. Up, up. And up. And down. Ready to open your legs. Leg. Here, and in, and down, pop, pop. Good job. And right, we're gonna cross our legs. Down, coming up, spin it. Spin the other way.
You know I'll treat you right, you give me fever.
gonna do our little spin on top of the chair. And again, lean. Good. Good job. All right. Cool. Next thing. Okay, did you guys do it? Were you able to do it? I hope. Okay. All right. Next thing we're going to try is we're going to try doing some stuff. This is going to take a little bit of ab work. And the more you do it and you practice it, the better you're going to get at it. Okay? But get on the side of your chair. All right? And we're going to point our toe. There. Point your toe out. And point, 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 point. I've got one hand on the back of my chair here. I've got one hand underneath my chair here, so I've got leverage and something to support me. So when you're doing this and you're getting started, you don't have to worry about, I can't do it. Hang on to something. These are like little crunches for your stomach, so good workout. Ready? And leg, now point your toe. You're going to point your leg, so kind of like there's like a hinge going through your leg here. So you're just going to move just your, at your knee to get started. So ready? And here, 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 here. Good. If you do the bigger hinges from your hip, it looks kind of weird sometimes. You can do it, but sometimes it's like getting started, it looks like a mess. Then you're like, you don't know what I'm doing. It comes later. But we will try another thing. So we just did our point, our toe point. Ready? Toe, point, point, point. Can you go up when you do it? Try it. Ready? One, two, three, four. Come down. Okay? Good. I'm starting to sweat, which is great. Okay. So other fun things that we can add, I'm taking like a mishmash of all different kinds of choreography from all different kinds of numbers, and we're putting them into a chair routine, okay? So the other thing you can do is, which I think is really cute, is you're gonna go on the side of your chair, you're gonna go on your hip, okay? Put your hand on the floor. You're on your hip. Your bottom leg is curled, and this leg is going up. You ready to try it again? Okay, you have to physically adjust yourself so you can go on your hip and go on the side of your hip, plant your hand on the ground, and leg up. Your other foot is curled around behind, otherwise it's gonna look like this and that's not pretty. Leg up. When you bring it down, keep your knee locked if you can. There we go. Slide toe, 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 okay? Let's try the other side. You find one side might work better for you than the other, right-handed, left-handed, same thing goes with right-hipped, left-hipped, hip. Okay, so you're gonna go onto your other side, onto your hip, plant your hand on the ground, leg up. Point your toe, hold it, and bring your leg down. Toe, 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 push up. Fun, huh? Good, you guys are doing great. We didn't do our workout from the other side, so our toe point on the other side, so let's do that next. All right, so hand, hand. Don't get too close to the edge. Don't get too far back. You don't want too much seat. You want to stay movement, your movement being mobile. So you've got to find that right spot so you can still move without falling off your chair. So bring your legs straight down like you're planking and bring them up. And bring them down. Plank it. Bring it up. And down one more time. And bring it up. Make your toes pretty. Good. There, we got a little bit of a workout already this morning there, didn't we? Cool. All right, you guys wanna try it with some music? I hope you guys are still having fun. Paul. That's too funny. All right, we'll try this. We'll try again from the top. All right, you guys ready? Here we go. Maybe just a little. WTF, man, she's a nut. I think that was awesome, and that was super fun, and I bet you guys did a great job. I would love it if you guys would show me what it is that you did. Take video of yourself doing it. So how about we do it one more time, and then we'll see how you guys do, and then you can alter it and change it to however you need to for your body type, for what your capabilities are, if you have any disabilities or physical issues, then just change your choreography however you want. But a chair workout, a chair routine, always takes a lot of strength and balance and discipline, and you need to practice and practice and practice. Cheyenne, you did it! Oh, that's so great! That's so cool! You should have stretched first, Nika. All right, let's do it again. We'll do it one more time, okay? And then we'll call it good. So this is exciting. Okay, all right, let's try it one more time, and we'll see how we do. All right, see, hopefully I don't forget it. All right, so we're coming in on our chair. I'm gonna turn it up just a little bit.
Legs open. You give me fever.
For. Does anybody have time as to when we started? I don't know. I guess it doesn't really matter so much, but all right. So you practiced your chair and you practiced your workout that way. There's all sorts of other things you can do for your chair if you want to incorporate your own little whatever you want to do with it. Before, when we stood on their chair, we did this, okay? And you did your leg over the back of the chair and then go over the front of the chair again with your other foot. Make sure that you know where you're standing when you do that. Okay, you can go down, but we went straight up. Can't be too afraid of heights. This is a great time for you to practice not being afraid of heights. And then move your hands, bring them all the way up if you want. You're standing on a chair. This is our chair workout class, right? So, and bringing them up. Just a little hip back and forth, you're bending your knees. Nice and easy, it's very fun, very simple, very cool, looks neat. But you're not gonna do anything too crazy while you're standing on your chair unless you practice over a period of time. So at this point for what we're doing today, we'll just take it nice and easy. So you're standing on your chair, great. When you go to get down from this height on your chair, grab the back of your chair with your hands when you're coming down. And then try to go ahead and spread your legs. You're gonna show them the goods. Oh yeah. So open, and then when you step off, how do you step off of this gracefully? I don't know. There's lots of different ways you can do it. Some people might just go ahead and drop down. I don't do that very gracefully, obviously. So other ways you can do it is you can just step off your chair and then cross your foot when you step off. It gives great form to like what it is you're working on, or you know, your appearance of how you're looking at stuff. So we just did up, and then we did up, we went up, dun, 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 dun. We come down, and yes, those are my knees that are cracking. This is what they do. And open your legs, and then close your legs, and step down, and step down. Cool. You guys did it. That was super. All right, what do you think? Did you have fun? Oh, we're at 30 minutes. Okay, cool. Okay, well, that was kind of my idea. Was I was like, let's just do like a little 30-minute workout, check it out video, and see how we do with all the stuff. I hope you guys had a good time. It was awesome. Let's do, just make sure that you stretch a lot. I'll just do a couple more moves that you can do. Let's see. Some people will just go up onto their chair and they'll walk across their chair. Okay? We did this whole thing where we straddled our chair here, tucking your butt right up next to the back of the chair. Pull your booty right up close so your butt's touching the back of the chair, and legs up, and do little leg circle things. Legs are open. Point your toe. Lead with your knees. All sorts of cool stuff you can do with a chair. You can hook your leg and pull yourself up. Eventually, if you're up for it, I know some people of you have done pole dancing, and then you do like backward body rolls. You can do that off of a chair. I'm not in the best shape for doing that right now. My neck is really bothering me. So I'm not going to do it today, but you can do a thing where since you're already over here, you can slide off the back of your chair onto the floor. I took Advil today, but I need to go to the chiropractor first. So there's all sorts of stuff you can do in your chair. Just be careful, be cautious. If you're trying new stuff that you don't know what you should be doing, or if it's safe for you to do, make sure that you have a spotter. If you're trying new things, have someone that's nearby. And then make sure, if you want to, since you're at home, do it on your carpet. It's a great time. It's much softer than a hardwood floor, so. Okay, on that note, I'm gonna say goodbye to everybody, and I hope that you guys will have a great day, and you continue to exercise and practice your planks, and we'll catch up with you some other time. So be well, stay safe, and know that I love you very much, and we'll see you again soon. All right, take care, bye.